Guys, it's Carter from 19. This is day four of my challenge day. And today I'm gonna learn computer graphics, not your network like previous record. Let's study. So I think this is enough for today's recording. I'm going to recap what I learned today. So today I learned a Monte Carlo, basic Monte Carlo integration. It is based on randomization technique, and this randomization is related to the probability and statistics. So we need to a review before we going deeper into Monte Carlo techniques. So basically, random variables is drawn from a certain domain, which can be discrete or continuous. And also we can convert this a random variable to another random variable using a function. And this denotes to y is equal to fx in this case. And the really simple example is that the dice example, when we roll a dice, we can get a value from 1 to 6. And each side of dice is has the same probability to generate a certain number, which the value that the side has. So in this case, the all of the side has the same probability, so it is called a uniform. Probability mass function means that a function px that gives us a discrete random variable's probability, like this kind of dice roll. The joint probability means that when the random variable x and y is independent of each other, then the px comma y can be represented as px multiplied py. On the other hand, when the x and y is dependent on each other, in this case, we call this as a conditional probability. So we can represent it as for the left term is equal to px, but for the right term is px by y, where which means that the px occurring of px is affected by the previous event of the y. And canonical uniform random variable means that all value in its domain 0 is equal to when the domain is x, x is equal to or greater or equal than 0 and less than 1. So, and independently uniform probability. And cumulative distribution function, which is called a CMF, no, CDF, is it represents as a certain range of probability, not the just only value. Continuous random variable means that values over ranges of continuous domain. And this PDF is really crucial thing to understand what is the Monte Carlo estimator. It's actually the relative probability of random variable taking a particular value and is the continuous analog of PMF. CDF. So honestly, it was kind of difficult to understand what this sentence mean in the text form. So I just searched it on image example in Google. Probability test function. So the probability density function seems like this. expected value function follow this, and so the Monte Carlo is matter. It approximates the value of arbitrary integral given the supply of independent uniform variables. The expected value of fn is equal to the integral. The derivation is following these above equation, we can substitute fn, which is the actual equation, the right term of fn, like this. But after then, following the properties of expected value, we can extract this sigma signature and some signature and this fractional part outside of EX. And then we can substitute EFXI is equal to here, this right term of this equation. So we can substitute. Then, because the probability density function is a uniform variable in here now, so we know that it is trivially the sum of px is equal to 1. So we can just substitute these b minus a, and the px will be b minus a. One of b minus a, so we can just remove it, this term. But there is no term in the integral related to I, so it's just simply same with n times integral a to b. So we can just also remove these parts either. And these parts saying that how we can expand the simple one-dimensional integration to a three-dimensional. So in this case, we set a range, some kind of cube, because we think we have three axes for x and y and z. And in this case, we can think the range as a cube. And the other steps is exactly same.
Yeah.
So this is the end of today's recording, and thanks for your watching. Bye.